will use influencing other people to advance our goals, to motivate others and to help them realize their own goals. Influencing happens all the time and in many different ways. As long as we inspire, motivate, pursue, seduce or use assertiveness, most people will agree that we are acting within the frame of healthy social life. Every now and then, however, we will use different tactics, we will manipulate people to get what we want. There are a lot of negative connotations connected to manipulating. The reason is that contrary to the first series of tactics, manipulation works with unfair means and does not respect the personal rights of the second party, now called the victim. It violates his integrity, works with hidden agendas, and deliberately uses dishonest tricks like false reasoning, blackmail and lying in an attempt to control the victim's action. Manipulation also is unbalanced. It is about exploiting the manipulator's advantages or purpose only of an event at the expense of the victim. So in theory, the difference is clear enough. Influencing is positive, manipulating is negative. Influencing is ethical, manipulating is not. In practice, it is often more difficult to know when you are being manipulated and how to best defend yourself against it. Manipulation is unbalanced. The manipulator is trying to benefit at your expense. Yet one of the tricks he will use to reach his goal is to convince you that you are the one who is to benefit most. How can you know whether a person is hiding information from you in attempt to mislead you? How can you be certain about the final intention of another person? It's often real difficult to recognize manipulation when it happens. After all, if we are aware that it is happening, would we allow ourselves to be manipulated? One of the reasons that we ignore to recognize manipulation is that it goes against the very basic of honest behavior. We want to be respected, appreciated, and loved from who we are. This implies that we avoid hurting others, avoid lying, feel we deserve the benefit of the doubt, and treat others as incarnate until proven guilty. Because we act like this, we assume others do too. Every now and then, however, we will meet with people that have a different approach to life. As a rule, it is safe to say that when things look like bullshit and smell like it, they usually are bullshit. When you feel uneasy about a relationship, when you have to give in too much, when you feel like having to walk on eggshell, when you feel guilty, humiliated, or in prayer after you and other difficult conversations, when choices become power games, when affection turns green with jealous or becomes overwhelming, exclusive and possessive, when there are half trust lies Daniels are facing, when everything that goes wrong somehow is your fault, when you feel you are pressured to take the decision you do not agree with, chances that you are being manipulated are very real. If you already know this, then you also a manipulator rarely comes unprepared. Feeling that you are being manipulated is one thing. Putting the finger on the right spot is much more difficult. Manipulation. What? Why? Who? How? Do you find yourself doing things that you don't really want when someone close to you or in a situation of power suggests that you do something against your will? How do you feel? Probably not good. How often do you experience or hear people who seem to have been blackmailed into accepting life-changing decisions? Such a choice of education, career, and marriage partner Chinese faces really anything. No wonder the manipulators come in all kinds, as we will see in the next chapters. All salesmen are trained in sales techniques, many of which are in fact manipulator techniques. Important, however, is to realize that everybody will try to manipulate others every now and then. Talk ethically never a good solution. In the real world, we will all sometimes use manipulation to win time, because the favor required is not important to prevent a major bet, to avoid arguments and frictions, because this is for a real noble cause. Manipulation becomes a problem only when the manipulator advances his own interests at the expense of this victim and causes mental, physical, financial or other harm. According to clinical psychologist Dr. George Simon, open manipulators in many ways are dysfunctional people who aggressive intentions and behaviors. Now the psychological vulnerabilities of the victims to determine what tactics are likely to be the most effective and have a sufficient level of ruthlessness to have no qualms about causing harm to the victim necessary. Manipulators also need to advance their own purpose and their own gain, even and virtually any cost to others. They need to attention feelings of power and superiority in relationship with other and need to feel in control. Dr. Richard Paul and Dr. Linda Elker write, "The human mind has no natural guide to the trust. Thus, it naturally loves the trust. What the human mind loves, it itself. What serves it, what flatters it, what gives it, what it wants, and what strikes down and destroys whether threatens it. Manipulators know his very well. They shrewdly focus on pursuing their own interests without respect to how the pursuit affects others. They know how to use the established structure of power to advance their interests. They have great command of the rhetoric of persuasion and are more sophisticated, more verbal, and generally have more schooling, great status, and achieve more success than uncritical person. They are accustomed to play the dominant role in relationships. They cannot effectively manipulate others if they appear to them to be invalidating their beliefs. That is why they are really rebels or critics of society. In fact, since they are fundamentally concerned not with advancing rational values, because with getting what they want, they are carefully to present themselves as sharing the values of tools they manipulate. For the same reason, they strive to appear before others in a way to associate